Welcome back to Afternoon Live. Are you lacking confidence when it comes to the physical relationship between you and your partner? Here with help, don't worry, we welcome back to the show couples therapist Megan Meganson with all of the answers. Hi, Megan.
Hi.
No pressure.
No pressure at all. That's exactly what we're talking about today, in fact.
Isn't that okay? So let's just get right on down to
it. Let's do it.
So clearly, the physical aspect of a relationship is super important.
Yeah.
How important is it?
It's crucial. And it's different for every couple. For some, physical intimacy is more important than for others. But some degree of physical connection in any relationship is vital to the overall health of that relationship.
Got you. So I think people understand that, right? Mm-hmm. And so is that where sometimes some anxiety will come in when it comes time to perform?
Right, exactly. Performance anxiety is the silent killer of good sex.
Really?
Yes.
Do tell.
Well, when we think about performance anxiety, we know that it's mostly an internal experience.
Right.
Right? It's the thoughts that are going through my mind when we're trying to have sex.
Mm-hmm.
So usually it starts as little seeds of self-doubt. Right? I'm doubting if my body's going to respond like I want it to respond.
Mm-hmm.
I'm doubting my ability to climax. I'm just doubting myself. Over time, that doubt turns into self-criticism,
right.
Turns into shame.
Mm-hmm.
We start talking to ourselves in really hurtful ways, right? I'm broken. I'm no good. I'm never going to be able to get this right.
Right. What's wrong with me?
What's wrong with me? Exactly. Inevitably, that kind of negative self-talk creates a sense of anxiety and pressure about being able to perform when you're trying to have sex.
So where does that come from, though? Is there something that happened in a past relationship,
mm-hmm.
or is it just the pressure too much that we build up in our head, or where does that come from?
So my theory is that it comes from this wonderful society that we live in.
Ah.
This society that tells us sex should be a certain way.
Gotcha.
Right? When we think about sex scenes in movies and on TV, they're hot and heavy,
mm-hmm.
and they look a very certain way.
Right.
We start with a magnetic eye contact, and we quickly move to intercourse. Everybody finishes, and then that's that.
Right.
So if we internalize that that's what sex is supposed to look like, and then we can't do that in the moment because we have normal bodies that don't respond with perfect consistency, the negative and the unrealistic expectations that are attached to these messages really instill in us a sense of anxiety about being able to measure up.
Got you. And then if your partner gives you any sort of shade around it,
yep.
well, now that's a whole nother level.
Exactly. It's sort of self-perpetuating at that point.
So then what can people do who experience performance anxiety do to overcome it?
Yes. So I'm going to give you two tips to overcome performance anxiety.
Okay.
The first tip is to have a conversation with your partner about shifting from goal-oriented sex, so sex that's intended to look a certain way.
Okay.
We start at point A, we end at point B.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's supposed to be like.
Mm-hmm.
We want to shift away from being goal-oriented, and we want to shift towards sex that's intended to help us connect.
What is that? Because in my mind, I mean, I'm just going to be honest with
you,
we always are, there is the A and then there's the B.
Yeah.
And the B you want to be.
Yes, yes.
So if that's not going to happen, or,
what's
you know.
What's the point?
Yeah, so what's all this, you know.
In between.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we all want B. Right?
Yes.
B is awesome.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, B is awesome.
But B is not always possible. So I'm going to give you my tip two, and then we'll tie them together.
Okay.
So this is an intervention that I use with my couples in sex therapy all the time. I want to talk to you about the five different types of touch we can share in our relationship. I like to use an analogy of gears. So think like the gears in your car.
Okay.
So we're going to start at first gear, and we're going to work up to fifth gear. I'm going to go kind of quickly. First gear is affectionate touch. That's hugging, snuggling, little kisses, PG rated.
Sure.
Second gear is sensual touch. This is touch that's designed to make me feel good but isn't sexual at all. So think like a good foot massage.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Okay, sure.
So something that really feels good and it's intimate but not sexual.
Okay.
Third gear is playful touch. Playful touch is sort of a combination of second gear and fourth gear, which is erotic touch.
Uh-huh.
So this is touch that's definitely intended to be sexual.
Okay.
And then fifth gear is intercourse.
Okay.
So if we look at that spectrum, we have affectionate touch all the way through intercourse.
Mm-hmm.
Performance anxiety sets in when we get stuck in a rhythm where we jump from one to five. affectionate to intercourse.
Okay.
And that's the expectation.
Okay.
So by adding in all of these phases in between and by talking about them with our partner, we can reduce our performance anxiety.
Oh, okay.
Right.
So basically, people need to stop driving automatics.
Yes.
And start getting back to manual shifting.
Exactly. So
gotcha.
Here's an example. Let's say we're in fourth gear together. Like, it's very erotic.
Yes.
And I start feeling anxious.
Oh, right.
As soon as I start feeling anxious, I want to tell my partner, I'm feeling too much pressure. Can we downshift?
Oh.
And then I want you to downshift to a lower intensity touch that doesn't feel so anxiety provoking.
Okay.
Right? And if you can do that, if you can stay in that lower level touch mm-hmm. until you're feeling relaxed, and then organically you move to the next phase, mm-hmm. you'll reduce your anxiety over time. It takes practice, and it takes really clear communication.
Okay.
But it works.
But you can get there eventually.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Whew, sounds like a long way to get to B, but you know what? It's worth it.
It's worth it, and you're going to have so many more Bs if you stick to this equation,
and
I promise.
And that's what we want.
Exactly.
That letter of the alphabet. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It's always great really having you here. You always have such wonderful tips for
people.
Thank you
for having
me. I think you really are helping folks.
Great.
All right, we're going to have more information about Megan and these tips on our website for you at katu.com. Don't go away. We will be right back.